Le passé simple. So this video will be divided in two parts. The first one will be covering l'utilisation, so when do we use le passé simple, and the second one will cover la formation, so how do we construct this passé simple tense. So we can start right now with l'utilisation, okay? And well, the main thing when we think about le passé simple, well, the first thing, it's a tense from the past, and then utiliser à l'écrit. So in most of the cases, you will see or you will encounter this passé simple form at a written form, okay? So dans la littérature, dans les récits historiques, dans les contes, dans les journaux. Okay, so in most of the cases, we will see these passé simple forms in literature, dans la littérature, historical stories, les récits historiques, fairy tales, les contes, and then newspapers, les journaux. Okay, and then keep in mind that it is quite rare à l'oral, assez rare à l'oral. So, dans le passé, in the past, of course, and you will express with le passé simple, une action, un fait, un événement. Okay, so it will be used in the past to express une action, an action, un fait, a fact, and then un événement, an event. Keep in mind that you don't have any connection with well, the time when you say or when you tell this thing at the past, okay? So, pas de connexion avec le moment de l'énonciation. And the last thing is that normally the person who will express this passé simple form will be somehow exterior to the story. So, la personne est extérieure au récit. Okay, so keep that in mind if you want to express in the past une action, un fait, or then un événement. Okay, don't have any connection with the time when the person is telling this past form. Okay, and then the person who is actually telling this past form is somehow exterior to the story. Okay. So, this is now how we will construct la formation du passé simple. And you will see that it's a bit tricky, so I've been making some groups and then subgroups, but then here are the groups. So, the first one is, well, the first group of regular verbs in French, you know, ending with er, okay? And for this group, well, the endings will be for je, AI, and then for tu, AS, il, elle, A, nous, A, accent circonflexe, MES, vous, A, accent circonflexe, TES, il, elle, at the plural form, E, accent grave, RENT. Okay, so you've got here your endings for the first group of verbs, so the regular verbs, AI, AS, A, A accent circonflexe, MES, A accent circonflexe, TES, E accent grave, RENT. Okay? And let's see now the endings for the group of the second. Sorry, the verbs of the second group and the regular verbs in IR, okay, so you will have for je, IS, and then for tu, IS, for il, elle, IT, for nous, I accent circonflexe, MES, vous, I accent circonflexe, TES, and then il, elle, at the plural form, IRENT. Okay, so we get these. There are the endings for the verb, the regular verbs from the second group, IR. Okay, so IS, IS, IT, IMES, ITES, IRENT. Okay, don't forget the circumflex here and here. So let's continue now, and we'll discover now, so it's a bit more tricky, So we're not talking about groups and subgroups, but we'll talk about the verbs that will have their participe passé, so past participles, in I en I. Okay, so remember, we're not talking about all the verbs in IR, for instance. And then je, so it will end with IS. Tu, it will end with IS. Il, elle, it will end with IT. Nous, I accent circonflexe MES, vous, I accent circonflexe TES, il, elle, IRENT. So of course you can tell me that, well, these endings are exactly the same as we saw previously. And yes, of course, because, well, all the regular verbs from the second group in IR do have their participe passé in like that, okay? But in this case, we're mostly talking about, and we'll see a few examples, about the verbs from the second group that do have their participe passé in I, okay? So let's continue now with these groups. So we're talking about the verbs ending with OER, but then, of course, as usual, I'm honest with you, and we're not talking about all the verbs, but most of them, okay? And the endings will go like je, US, tu, US, il, elle, UT. Okay. Nous, U accent circonflexe MES, vous, U accent circonflexe TES, il, elle, URENT. Okay, so keep in mind these endings, so US, US, UT. U accent circonflexe MES, U accent circonflexe TES, URENT. And we're talking about the verbs ending with OER, but remember, not all the verbs. Let's see now another category, OIRE. And then, as usual, remember, we're not talking about all the verbs, but most of them. And the endings will go like je, US, tu, US, and then il, elle, UT, okay. Nous, U accent circonflexe MES, vous, U accent circonflexe TES, il, elle, URENT. Okay, so remember, verbs ending with OIRE, but not all verbs, US, US, UT, U accent circonflexe MES, U accent circonflexe TES, URENT. Okay, and we'll continue with the verbs that do have their participe passé en U. Okay, remember, not all the verbs, of course, but most of them. And the endings will be je, US, tu, US, il, elle, UT, nous, U accent circonflexe MES, vous, U accent circonflexe TES, il, elle, URENT. Okay? And then verbs like tenir and venir, they are a bit tricky, so be careful. We're talking about these two verbs, but then, of course, all the composed verbs based on tenir and venir. Okay? So let's see now. And then je, INS, tu, INS, il, elle, INT, nous, INMES, vous, INTES, il, elle, INRENT. Okay. So, we'll now see few examples, quelques exemples. And now I will focus on the pronunciation. Okay, so let's start with the first group. So, les verbes en ER, and then the example is parler. Okay? Je parlais, tu parlas, il parla, elle parla, nous parlâmes, vous parlâtes, ils parlèrent, elles parlèrent. Okay, so one more time. Je parlais, tu parlas, il parla, elle parla, nous parlâmes, vous parlâtes, ils parlèrent, elles parlèrent. And now, the second group of verbs ending with er, so the regular one, and I've been choosing this finir to finish or to end example. Je finis, tu finis, il finit, elle finit, nous finîmes, vous finîtes, ils finirent, elles finirent. Okay, so one more time. Je finis, tu finis, il finit, elle finit, nous finîmes, vous finîtes, ils finirent, elles finirent. And now let's see all the verbs that will have their participe passé en I. Remember, it was not all the verbs, so I've been choosing this suivre verb to follow. Je suivis, tu suivis, il suivit, elle suivit. Nous suivîmes, vous suivîtes, ils suivirent, elles suivirent. Okay, so one more time. Je suivis, tu suivis, il suivit, elle suivit. Nous suivîmes, vous suivîtes, ils suivirent, elles suivirent. And now, let's see a few verbs. So, like, attendre, so it's to wait. Dire, to say. Entendre, to hear. Faire, to do. Mettre, to put, sorry. And then, voir, to see. J'attendis, tu dis. Il entendit, elle entendit. Nous fîmes, vous mîtes. Ils virent, elles virent. Okay, so, j'attendis, tu dis. Il entendit, elle entendit. Nous fîmes, vous mîtes. Ils virent, elles virent. All right, so. Let's continue now with this group. Remember, verbs ending with O-E-R, but we said that it was not all the verbs, so I've been choosing this recevoir example, to receive, recevoir, and it goes like that. Je reçus, tu reçus, il reçut, elle reçut, nous reçûmes, vous reçûtes, ils reçurent, elles reçurent. Okay, so one more time. Je reçus, tu reçus, il reçut, elle reçut, nous reçûmes, vous reçûtes, ils reçurent, elles reçurent. And now the verbs ending with O-E-R-E, and remember I said that we're not talking about all the verbs, but most of them, and for this example I've been taking boire. Boire is to drink. Je bus. Tu bus, il but, elle but, nous bûmes, vous butes, ils burent, elles burent. Okay, so one more time. Je bus, tu bus, il but, elle but, nous bûmes, vous butes, ils burent, elles burent. And now the verbs that will have their participe passé en U. So I've been choosing this lire verb, so lire is to read. Je lus, tu lus, il lut, elle lut, nous lûmes, vous lûtes, ils lurent, elles lurent. Okay, so one more time. Je lus, tu lus, il lut, elle lut, nous lûmes, vous lûtes, ils lurent, elles lurent. And now, venir, venir is to come, so remember they were a bit tricky. So we're talking about venir and all the verbs that will be formed with venir. Je vins, tu vins, il vint, elle vint, nous vîmes. Remember, it's quite tricky to pronounce that. Vîmes. Vous vintes, ils vinrent, elles vinrent. Okay, so one more time. Je vins. Tu vins, il vint, elle vint, nous vîmes, vous vintes, ils vinrent, elles vinrent. And then as I said, tenir, so exactly the same thing as we had for venir, so we're talking about tenir And all the verbs that will be composed based on tenir, okay? So, je teins, tu teins, il teint, elle teint, nous teîmes, same thing, same tricky phonetical thing here, nous teîmes, okay? Vous teintes, il teint, elle teint. One more time, je teins, tu teins, il teint, elle teint, nous teîmes, vous teintes, il tinrent, elles tinrent.